Hello, my name is Rob Sansom. I'm a paleontologist at the University of Manchester. I work on early vertebrates, fishes and taphonomy, questions of how things are preserved. And today we're going to do an unboxing video with a difference. It's going to be fossils. I have here a large box of fossils that I have yet to open. This is part of a project that I've been working on with Peter Tarrant, an excellent collector of fossils who works in Shropshire. He's found a new site where we went to go and explore some lovely thingies like this heterostracan, an early fossil jawless fish from the Devonian period of Shropshire. He's very kindly sent us specimens for us to look at and analyse at the University of Manchester. So I haven't seen these. This is the first time I'm going to be doing that. So I'm going to unbox them with you now. This is the box. This contains some specimens labelled as Kephalaspis. So let's have a little look. So inside we have some specimens wrapped in paper. This is from 2014. A cricket from the advertiser. Let's have a quick look. Oh, straight away into some lovely looking specimens here. This is the very nice ventral surface of an osteostracan. That's a particular type of Devonian fish. Here is where its mouth would have been at the top there. And then here is the cornua. I mean, we can't see what it looks like because this is the underside. It would have breathed and ate through this particular side with these pointy bits at the side. Very nice specimen. Ah, oh, cool. If we look at it from this side, we can see the internal anatomy. Not quite well, I'm trying to, there you go. Here we can see the ventral surface. This would have been its dorsal surface. Inside, these specimens have all sorts of preserved anatomy. They had this really cool situation where they would ossify bits of the internal anatomy, so we get to see it. So that one's a really cool specimen because it has both the mix of internal, external and ventral bits and pieces. Super cool. Okay, let's take a look at the next one. This one's going back in time now, as evidenced from the newspaper here. This one's a rather smaller isolated bit of osteostracan. This one might be the dorsal surface. Lovely. Ah, there's the more complete thing. Here we can see what the more complete specimen looks like. We've got the eyes there and a median field where it might have done some electroreception activity. In the middle of that, you might just be able to make out some other sensory organs. So this one's a bit incomplete, but perhaps these specimens are part of the same one. Ah, yes, we can begin to piece these together and see that they would have fit together like this. Let's have a look if there's any other little friends to go with that. Another part of a similar osteostracan little friend. Here we can just about make out the little grooves and canals that would have carried those sensory apparatus. Lovely. There's one more specimen in this box. Let's want to have a look at now. Oh no, there's two more. Okay, that one's just a fragment associated with the other ones. This is an absolutely cracking specimen. Look at this here. We can see the lovely preservation of this one here. We've got, I'm trying to see if I can angle it so we can see that well. Let's try it up this way. There we go. Now we can see the eyes, the lateral fields, the central field, all sorts of bits, and the cornua on the side. A very lovely specimen. What's cool about this one is that we also have the cheeky heterostracan has catched a lift on there alongside that one. Very nice. So Peter's identified the species for those ones. Lovely. Not so sure about which ones are which. So that was the first specimens, the first box of specimens from this new site in Shropshire. And our attempt to unbox these. We've got some other boxes over here that we might open up if there's interest. And we'll have a look those specimens another time. Follow along for more.